Hello, how are you? I hope everyone is gesund, stark, and veilig, pagash misabiruchnis, healthy, strong, and happy physically and spiritually. Tonight, I want to talk about a subject which I believe is very, very important. And in a way, it's really basics, but sometimes it's overlooked. And it's something that has to be stressed again and again. And how much it's stressed, it's not enough. And that is the idea of a sense of kinship, of a community. So there's one idea of Ahavas Yisrael, we love every Jew. Why? Because he's a Jew. And Chabad Lubavitch's record in this area is clear. And we get good marks. We have Chabad houses throughout the whole world. A Chassid, a Lubavitcher will become a Shliach and move away from his entire family 10,000 miles away, go somewhere where there's nothing happening and create a community and be there to reach out and touch every other Jew and to help him in any way he can. That's one idea. But then there's another idea. You live in a community, Borough Park, Williamsburg, Crown Heights, Melbourne, London. You live in a community and there's members of your community, your synagogue. And just like when we talk about charity, we say, the poor people of your community take precedence. So too, let's not make it that there's a contrast or that we have to negate something, but so too, there's a level of involvement, of care and interest that you should have towards your neighbor, towards the kids of the same class, your friends of the same unit in the army. It's a different level. It's not meant to negate anything. And it should be simple. So where do we see this, for example? We'll start with a pasuk from the Rebbe's capital, pasuk Samach Gimel, which is a beautiful pasuk. It says, Chover Oni L'chol Asher Yireucho U'L'Shomrei Pikudecho. I am a friend to all who fear you and to those who keep your precepts. So it doesn't mean to negate, God forbid. As the saying, as good is good, is better and better. If good is good, is better, not better. It's not meant to negate another Jew who may not be so observant, but it is meant for you to proclaim your priorities in life. What are your virtues? What are your values? What do you stand for? So you turn to Hashem and you say, by the way, I'm with you. I'm a fan of goodness and kindness, of mitzvahs, etc. Just like somebody says he's a member of a certain organization. The word chover over here means friend, but it also is used in Hebrew when you talk about somebody being a member of an organization. There's chever shas. Some people need to learn in Talmud. If you're a member of the American Heart Association, that means you care about the idea of the health of the heart in a human body, and so on and so forth. So tovi, we turn to Hashem, we say, Chover oni l'chol asher yireucho l'shem pikudecho. We are a member, we are on the same team, we're allies, especially with those that have your interests in mind, Hashem's. And that is truthfully, for those who learn Chassidus, there's a maimer I'm learning right now, Svartim Tavshin Yud Aleph, from 1951, a discourse which talks about attributes and character traits in serving God. And over there he says, what is chesed? Shebechesed. That means you love those that love Hashem. And he says, you see somebody who is following on the right path, you show a special love towards that person. So, I want to say a story. This week was the birthday of the Reb Maharash. This is one of my all-time favorite stories. And it's so amazing. And I'm going to read it quickly and leave out maybe some details. And you look it up, you can look it up on your own. And that is from Sefer HaSichas Tavshin Hei, page 95. That's a story that the Rebbe Maharash, the fourth Lubavitcher Rebbe, told his son, the Rebbe Rashab, the fifth Lubavitcher Rebbe, about two people that came to him for yichidus, for a private audience. He said, I had two guests today. From one of them I had a great pleasure, and from the other one a deep pain. Who was the first guest that came? Reb Elye Abeler. He came into the Rebbe, and the Rebbe asked him, how are you? And he said, Baruch Hashem. He He says, how's your business? Baruch Hashem. And then Reb Elye cries out to the Rebbe, no Rebbe, ich hab grace tzar von Yosefin, I have much pain from Yosef, welch gefinzer bei uns in Yeshu, that is a member of our settlement. Er hat eppes kein Hatzloch in it leilenu und kein Zach. He has no success in anything. Man hat sich zusammengekleidt, man hat sich zusammengelegt und ihm gekäft a Pferd und Wagen, er soll keinen vorderen Stadt mit a bissl Schere, trefft bei ihm alle Mola Takola. We raised some funds to buy a wagon for him to be able to buy and sell merchandise. Every accident happens. The axe to brech sich, the axle broke, the Pferd to brech tafus, the horse breaks a leg. Nachher gam min im Aruis, then all of his merchandise was stolen. Alle schlamazlen treffen sich bei ihm. And Abelia says, was kann ich ihm helfen? How can I help him? Und hat abgesifzt und sich voneinander gewähnt, sorgendig, and he started broke down and started sobbing. And he says, Rebbe, git him a broche. Rebbe, give him a blessing. Rebbe Maharash told him, yes, you can help him a lot. When one Jew feels the pain of another Jew, and he asks for him, with that alone, he takes away many, many decrees and judgments and breaks it. Then the Rebbe Maharash took out a small coin from his pocket and he gave it to Reb Elye and he said, Ich will sein mit dir a Shutif. I want to be a partner with you. The Rebbe says, all the help and soll's kennen ton a Yidna Teve und soll sein Batzloch. He gave him a coin. He says, I want to be a partner with you, that when you do a Jew a favor, it should be successful. So his coin was his hishtatvus, his being a part of that favor, that help that this chosid would then give to Reb Yosef. And then it says, Reb Elye says, Rebbe, you want to become a partner with me? You know who I am. Anyways, see there. Then the Reb Maharash told the Reb Rashab that the other one who came to him that day was some Reb Eliezer. He was a writer and author of Svarim. He was a big scholar. He ran a kollel of Jungalite, young married men that were learning. The Rebbe asks him, was herzich? And he says, he has Baruch Hashem Ashirli Yunda mit Jungalite. They learn in depth. He learns in depth. He teaches in depth Talmud with these young men. And the Shabbos, the Ma'arich B'tfilosim Nochaminyin, they daven also in depth and for a long time. They learn Chassidus. So then the Rebbe Maharash says, "Um wie ist mit Middes? How are their character traits?" So Eliezer answered, "Wie gvirish yungalait, like rich kids." He meant it over in a negative way, like they're like probably spoiled or they're into themselves, whatever. So then the Rebbe Maharash turns to this scholar, the head of the whole institution of the Kol, he says, the shuld is mitzad ha-mechanech, the fault lies in the educator. Nitzeir, it's not their fault. Reish is calling chinuch v'adrocha, the first thing in education is midas toivas, to teach and educate about good character traits. Unit lenin dem sefer no zich lenin. Not that you're studying a book, but you learn how to adapt with the values of the book into yourself that you change. So when you return home, make a free loan fund. They should give away, those people studying by you should give away 50% of the dowry. So he tells the Rebbe, they're not going to listen to me. So the Rebbe tells him, tell them I said that. And tell them when they give, they're not giving theirs. And if they don't give, they're going to lose it all. And then the Rebbe Maharash finished. And there was kum dem zweiten Mal. When you come back another time, sollst du mir bringen a besseren Gruß, you should bring me better regards. And then, here comes a line which you don't find anywhere else in all of Chabad literature. The Rebbe Maharash, when he finished telling his son the story about the two guests, he said, "Wenn ich wollt, gewollt noch geben mein nefesh elikis, if I have given into my nefesh elikis, into my godly soul, wollt ich Reb Elye Abeler ausgekuscht, I would have kissed Reb Elye Abeler." Ausgekuscht means more than gekuscht. means like I would kiss him all over. So here we see a story, a contrast. The Rebbe says, I had two guests. One comes and expresses and is pained by the pain of another chassid. And him, concerning him, the Rebbe says, I would have kissed him. I could kiss him. That's how precious it is. That's how important it is. And the other one who comes and speaks about the advancements in scholarship and in learning Torah and how they're davening. But when it comes to the midos are not such midos toivos. He says, you know what? Next time, tell me better news. So this is what we have to realize. The subject over here is not about loving all Jews, which of course is true. We're talking about, like in the story of Reb Elye Abeler, we're talking about your love for your neighbor, your love for a member in your community. It's called Ahavas Chassidim, Ahavas Reyim. And it's a virtue, and it's meant to be, and it doesn't negate anything else. And this is like what it says in the Pasuk, Chaverani, L'chaleshe Yireucha, U'lashemi Pikudecha. And as a matter of fact, there's Hayom Yom of the Rebbe in the Hayom Yom of Gimel Adar Alef. It says these words, and I'm just going to tell you what it says and translate. Rabbeinu Hazaken Amar, the Alter Rebbe said, Mitzvahs Ahavas Yisrael, Hu Liyilidam Yisrael, L'shem Ha'olam Leira Oysoi. The Alter Rebbe taught that the mitzvah of Ahavas Yisrael, loving a fellow Jew, applies to every member of the Jewish people, even if one has never seen him. How much more does it apply to a member of the Jewish neighborhood in which one lives, to every man or woman who is a member of one's own community? The Ebishah should help, that we should improve, I should improve in this. And this will cause a ברכנו אבינו, כולנו כאחד, that our being a person that cares about members of his own community shows an interest. Someone calls you, return the call. Someone sends you an email, respond to the email. Someone writes you a WhatsApp, answer the WhatsApp. Find out what's going on with your neighbor. And be a friendly person and be nice. The things some of us have to work on because they might not come so naturally. So through that will be ברכנו אבינו, כולנו כאחד. It will bring the Gula Mitzvah Shlema now. Posting from Melbourne, Be'ez Hashem Yisbarech, your man in Melbourne.